Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, we'll do the current affairs of today, that is 16th of February. So let's start the video. We'll start with the quiz today. The level of the quiz is moderate. Ajay Warrior, it is a joint military exercise between India and which country? Ajay Warrior. Which bird is the mascot for UN Convention of Conservation of Migratory Species, that is COP13? Basically, CMS is an organization that works to conserve the migratory species of birds and other animals also. And its 13th meeting is taking place recently in India. So you need to tell me which bird is the mascot for the same. American Factory. This question is tough. American Factory won the Oscar for the best feature-length documentary. Who produced it? Basically, American Factory, this documentary is produced by a very important person. Who is he? Which Indian celebrity is at the top spot in the latest brand valuation study by Duff and Phelps? So who or which Indian celebrity, you know, has the maximum brand value in India? What is the name of India's 13th major port? And you can also tell me in which state it is being set up. Operation Nakal, it was started by which city police? Operation Nakal. Bharatanatyam is a dance. It is a dance, classical dance. It belongs to which state? Bharatanatyam. Sikariya Mega Food Park was opened in which state recently? And it is the first mega food park of this state called Sikariya. There is this storm called Kiara. Kiara storm recently hit several countries of which continent? So which continent did Kiara hit? What is the capital of New Zealand? What is the capital of New Zealand? Children's Protection Fund was launched by which person? Children's Protection Fund for India. Which country recently launched the International Religious Freedom Alliance to make sure that the other countries in the world have adequate religious freedom? Presidential Medal of Freedom, it is awarded by which country? So there is this award called Presidential Medal of Freedom. It is the highest civilian award. Just like in India, we have Bharat Ratna, which is the highest civilian award. Similarly, Presidential Medal of Freedom is the highest civilian award of which country? The 5x20 rule is related to which ministry? 5x20 rule. Who is the Chief Minister of Mizoram? The northeastern state of Mizoram. There is this name called Askini. Askini is the Vedic name of which Indian river? Which Indian river was called Askini in the Vedic times? Rani Ki Vav. This is a World Heritage Site in Gujarat. Rani Ki Vav. This motif is on which rupee note? On which rupee note, the back side, that is the reverse side, you will find Rani Ki Vav motif. Tania Bhatia is associated with which sport? Tania Bhatia. Who is the Chief of Air Force India? Who heads Indian Air Force? Baglihar Dam is located in which state? Baglihar Dam. So that's it. Now let me tell you the answers. Ajay Warrior is a joint military exercise between India and UK. United Kingdom. Ajay Warrior. And this exercise has recently started between the two countries. Which bird is the mascot for American Convention of Conservation of Migratory Species? First of all, you need to tell me, you need to know that this convention is taking place in Gandhinagar in Gujarat. So it's taking place in Gandhinagar. And the bird is Great Indian Bustard. Great Indian Bustard is also called Godavan in Rajasthan because it is the state bird of Rajasthan. So that also you need to know. Now, the bird is Great Indian Bustard, therefore, which is the mascot. And this conference is taking place in Gandhinagar. American Factory, this documentary, and it won the Oscar also, is produced by Barack Obama. Yeah, that's right, Barack Obama. And Barack Obama, you know, is the former president of America, two times president of America. He was from Democratic Party. He was from Democratic Party. Then the Indian celebrity that is at the number one position in the brand valuation is Virat Kohli. So Virat Kohli was number one, Akshay Kumar was number two. India's 13th major port is coming up in Maharashtra. It is called Vadhavan Port. V-A-D-H-A-V-A-N, Vadhavan Port is the name of the port, which is the latest port in India. Operation Nakal was started by Ghaziabad police. You know that Ghaziabad is in UP. So it was started by Ghaziabad police. Bharatanatyam dance belongs to Tamil Nadu. It is the classical dance of Tamil Nadu. Sikariya is the name of the mega food park that is coming up in Tripura. And it is the first mega food park of Tripura. The storm Kiara recently hit Europe. It hit many countries like Germany, like Spain, like Greece. A lot of countries were hit by Kiara, even Norway. New Zealand capital is Wellington. V-E-L-L-I-N-G-T-O-N. Wellington is the capital of New Zealand. And there is this currency called New Zealand dollar, which they use. Children's Protection Fund was launched by Prince Charles. Prince Charles of Britain, he launched Children's Protection Fund. The country that launched International Religious Freedom Alliance is America, and a lot of countries are a member of this alliance, but it was initiated by America. Presidential Medal of Freedom is awarded by America again. And if you remember, last year, this award was given to the golf player Tiger Woods. Tiger Woods. 5x20 rule is related to the Ministry of Civil Aviation. What is this rule and why this rule has been broken recently? So the thing is this. There are two types of airlines. One is the domestic airline. One is the international airline. Right? For an airline to start international flights, there are two conditions. One, it should have 5 years of domestic experience. Right? So for example, if you start an airline today, then for the next 5 years, you cannot fly it outside India. That is rule number one. 5 years of domestic experience is a must. Second rule is that the airline should have minimum 20 aircrafts if it has to fly internationally. So the fleet of the airline should have 20 aircraft and 5 years experience for it to go international. This is called 5x20 rule. Now, why this rule was broken? Because Alliance Air. So you know that Alliance Air is a subsidiary of Air India. Alliance Air has started the flight to Sri Lanka and it did not follow 5x20 rule. That is why this rule was in news. The Chief Minister of Mizoram is Zoramthanga. Zoramthanga. Askini is the Vedic name of Chenab River. C-H-E-N-A-B, Chenab River. Remember, Chenab is the largest tributary of the Indus River. Ravi, Bias, Satluj, Jhelum, Chenab. These are the 5 biggest tributaries of Indus River and Chenab is the biggest of all. And by the way, Chenab is also called Chandrabhaga River. In Himachal, some parts it is called Chandrabhaga River also. And Askini is its Vedic name. Rani Ki Vav motif you will find on 100 rupee note. On the 100 rupee note, you will find on the back side Rani Ki Vav. Tania Bhatia is the wicketkeeper of the Indian cricket team. So Tania Bhatia is the wicketkeeper. She represents cricket. So she is a cricket player. Tania Bhatia is the wicketkeeper of the Indian cricket team, women's cricket team. Who is the chief of the Air Force India? It is RKS Bhadauria. I think this was pretty straightforward. RKS Bhadauria, he took over from BS Dhanwa. And Bagli Hardam, of course, is in Jammu and Kashmir. Jammu and Kashmir. So these were the 20 interesting questions today. And since the level was moderate to difficult, I don't expect you to score more than 10. But okay, if you have, then very good. Now let's start the current affairs of today. Which country has the cheapest mobile data plan in the world as per a report by cable.co.uk? It's a quite popular website. So remember, it's a worldwide mobile data pricing website. Analyzes it. According to it, India has the cheapest mobile data in the world. Let me show you the photo that is available on their website. You can see India ranks number one, Kyrgyzstan ranks number two, Kazakhstan ranks number three. So the two Central Asian countries, Kyrgyzstan and Kazakhstan, they are ranked at number two and number three respectively. And India has the cheapest data. Which city will host the first ever
Northeast Indian Fund Fest. This is to attract the investments by the corporates. It will take place in Vivanta by Taj, that is the Taj Hotel in Guwahati in Assam, on 28th of February, right? And this is basically an initiative to attract investments in the Northeast. So the answer is Guwahati in Assam. Apiary on Wheels, a concept for beekeeping, is designed by which organization? Basically, apiculture is what we call the rearing of the honeybees for getting honey and bee wax and other products. It can augment the income of the farmer, and it is therefore a allied activity of agriculture. Now, apiary is a place where the honeybees are kept. Apiary on Wheels is a moving apiary, and this concept has been started by the KVIC, Khadi and Village Industries Commission. KVIC, Khadi and Village Industries Commission. Now, recently, remember that Khadi and Village Industries Commission, they launched a watch in association with Titan, and the strap of the watch is made up of Khadi. It was launched by Nitin Gadkari. In fact, Nitin Gadkari launched this apiary on wheels as well. Why? Because Nitin Gadkari is the minister for MSME. And if you are talking about KVIC, then most industries in KVIC are of course MSME. Which has become the first union territory in India to pass a resolution against Citizenship Amendment Act? Now, the first state in India to pass a resolution against Citizenship Amendment Act was Kerala. But here they are asking which is the first union territory. You can guess it. It's very easy. So it's Pondicherry. Why? Because in Pondicherry, we have the Congress government. V. Narayana Swamy is the chief minister. Kiran Bedi is the lieutenant governor of Pondicherry. Which state has launched the Gyan Deepika scholarship scheme? Gyan Deepika scholarship scheme, and there is another scholarship called HPC scholarship scheme. So what are these schemes about? Both of these schemes have been started by Assam government, and they were launched in Guwahati on 12th of February. So under the Gyan Deepika scholarship, it will provide a subsidy of 700 per month. Gyan Deepika scholarship, 700 per month scholarship will be provided for 10 months. 700 per month for 10 months through direct benefit transfer, right, to the hostel students of government colleges and state university, and more than 13,000 students will benefit. And then there is something known as HPC scholarship. HPC stands for Hindustan Paper Corporation. Hindustan Paper Corporation, there are these factories of HPC at Pachgram and Jaggi Road, etc. So the students will be provided scholarship up to 1 lakh rupees for higher education. This was announced by Hemanta Biswa. Who has won the prestigious Dan David Prize for her expensive work in the fields of population policies? Now, expensive here does not mean costly. It is expansive, which means lot of work. In the field of population policy, it is Geeta Sen. India, she is from India, of course, and she is one of the pioneers in the feminism, and she is also a social activist. Geeta Sen was awarded this award. Now, Geeta Sen right now teaches at Harvard University. The Indian Railways is planning to run a new train based on which mythology? It was announced recently. So remember, they will run Ramayana Express. They will run Ramayana Express. And basically, this train will have Ramayana themed interiors. Ramayana themed interior, and also religious songs will be played to the passengers when they are traveling in this train. This train will be launched by the Railway Board Chairman V.K. Yadav on 10th of March. On 10th of March. PAN number, permanent account number, will become inoperative if it is not linked with Aadhaar by which date? So remember, the deadline is 31st March 2020. Already a lot of extensions have been given, but probably this will be the last because a financial year is ending. So 31st March this year, if your PAN is not linked to the IT, income, your Aadhaar, then your PAN can become inoperative. So the answer is 31st March 2020. Go Air will appoint which person as their CEO? So Go Air is appointing Mr. Vinay Dubey. Mr. Vinay Dubey, and Go Air is undergoing some tough time. In fact, most of the airlines are undergoing a very tough time right now. So the answer is Vinay Dubey. Also remember, the chairman of Airport Authority of India is Arvind Singh. Arvind Singh is the chairman of Airport Authority of India. And recently, Mr. Rajiv Bansal was made the chairman of Air India. Union Minister Nitin Gadkari has launched India's first intercity electric bus service between Mumbai and which city? India's first intercity electric bus service was launched between Mumbai and Pune. Mumbai and Pune. Electric bus service means the bus will be charged with current and the source of energy for the bus will be the electricity. The capacity is 43-seater. It's a 43-seater bus and it can operate 300 kilometers by charging it for the one time. And also remember, the Ministry of Union Transport in India, they have a target of converting all the buses into electric vehicle by 2022. Which Union Territory will host the Khelo India Winter Games? Khelo India Winter Games will take place in Ladakh, Union Territory of Ladakh. R.K. Mathur is the Lieutenant Governor of Ladakh. And the Khelo India University Games, Khelo India University Games will be taking place in Bhubaneswar. And Khelo India Youth Games recently took place in Khelo India University Games took place in Bhubaneswar and Youth Game in Guwahati. Odisha has announced a hike of what percent dearness allowance for the government employees? The dearness allowance is allowance that is given to offset the inflation, and 5% will be the increase in the dearness allowance. So with this, the employees will now get 10% of their arrear salary arising out of revision of pay under Odisha rules, you know. So the answer is 5% is the increase in the dearness allowance for Odisha employee. It will benefit 3.5 lakh state government employees. The Union government has sanctioned how many medical colleges for Jammu and Kashmir? In Jammu and Kashmir, 9 medical colleges will be set up. And out of the 9 medical colleges, 2 will be AIMS. 2 will be AIMS, All India Institute of Medical Science. Now, 1 AIMS will be set up in Vijaypur, District Samba. In Samba, this was announced last year. Now, whether it has been set up still, I don't know, but 1 AIMS was announced for Samba. SEBI has constituted, Securities and Exchange Board of India, headed by Ajay Tyagi, has constituted a Municipal Bonds Development Committee, which will be headed by which person? It will be headed by Mr. Sujit Prasad. He is the Executive Director in SEBI. Mr. Sujit Prasad will head this Municipal Bonds Development Committee. Sonam Sherpa passed away. He was the founding member and lead guitarist of which music band? He was the lead guitarist of the Parikrama band. He was only 48 years old and he passed in West Bengal. He was born in Kalimpong in West Bengal. Which state has radio tagged an Indian pangolin for the first time in order to know its ecology? Pangolin, remember, February 15 was the World Pangolin Day, and Madhya Pradesh radio tagged the first ever Indian pangolin. Pangolin is one of the most hunted animals in India, by the way. And remember, it was the 9th World Pangolin Day, which was on 15th of February. Which state has launched the Pyar Ka Paudha campaign to promote the practice of planting trees? It's a potential afforestation campaign which has been started in Bihar. And it means, Pyar Ka Paudha means plant of love. Plant of love. So it was started in Bihar government to promote planting of trees. Which state has decided to replace Yash Bharati Awards with State Cultural Award? Yash Bharati Awards will be replaced by the government of UP. And now it will be called a State Cultural Award. Basically, this is the highest honor, highest award of government of Uttar Pradesh. And so the answer is UP. Which country will be India's partner country at the Technology Summit 2020 that will take place in Delhi? For the Technology Summit, remember, Portugal will be the partner country. Portugal will be the partner country. And you know that the Portuguese president was on a visit to India. India and Portugal, they have signed 14 agreements. 1-4. Total 14 agreements have been signed with Portugal.
General Insurance Corporation of India, GICRE, which is the only public sector reinsurance company of India, has received license from which international bank to commence the reinsurance business in the country? So remember, GICRE has got the license from Bank of Russia. So therefore, it will start the reinsurance business now in Russia. So that's it. That was a video for 16th of February. See you very soon. God bless you. Take care.